Hey, what's up, y'all? My name is Devontae, and I sacrificed my time so you don't have to. On God, I was not planning on dropping a video today. I have to wake up early in the morning because I have to go to work early in order to get off a little bit early. I put this in like maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago. I need to get off early because I have to be there to review All In. And All In's going to come on at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I won't be getting back home till probably around 2 because I get off at 1. That's the earliest I can get off, meaning I have to go in at 5 o'clock in the morning, right? So I said to myself, okay, let me prepare for the editing and get everything set up right now. So when I get in, all I got to do is just go directly to recording, right? Just watching the show and recording. So I was not planning on doing anything today, but just, you know, getting everything set up for tomorrow. And of course, I'm at this point right now, on God, bro, I'm not even joking. If you call me conceited, call me arrogant, call me egotistical, call me narcissist, whatever, okay? I swear to God, she's doing this on purpose just to fucking egg me on. Obviously, I'm being hyperbolic, but goddamn, how much stupid shit does one person have to say, bro? How much stupid shit does one person have to fucking say? What are you doing? What is this, bro? Okay, this is coming from WrestleOps, okay? It's coming from WrestleOps. Mercedes Mone states that the difference between WWE and AEW is night and day. Mind you, once again, Sasha Banks with WWE's dick all up inside her mouth, right? Is what it is. Okay. She says, and I quote, "The difference between the two companies is night and day. In WWE, you have no idea what you'll be doing week to week. But here in AEW, I have space to be heard. Along with Tony Khan and with my friend and personal writer, Jennifer Pepperman, there's time to sit down and really plan out the kinds of stories we want to tell. I'm treated with genuine respect, and I really feel seen in a way I sometimes haven't been before. I love it so much here." So first off, I mean, God, could this shit sound any more faker, bro? I swear to God. Kamala Mone strikes again, man. All she was missing was the cackle, right? I mean, she even has a cackle, right? Like, just like Kamala. They both have cackles. She even has the horrific fucking hysterical laugh. But I guess Sasha is more like, because she has to exaggerate her man voice. Okay, bruh, there's so much retardation. I feel my IQ points slipping the more and more I hear about an AEW person, specifically a former WWE person, talking shit about AEW. Because we know, before I even talk about this, and again, it's to the point of annoyance, because you know how this typically goes. Whether it's AEW, you can go on the past, talk about TNA, you can talk about WCW, it all ends up the same way. I don't even know why it's even worth burning the bridge, because you know eventually you're going to cross back over that bridge. Every fucking wrestler who once was a star in WWE and then inevitably leaves, they almost always come back. Unless death has done something to them, they always come back. Recently, CM Punk, same situation, was in lawsuits with WWE, right? Literally lost one of his good friends because he himself went to go do stuff with WWE. Literal bad blood. Going almost over a decade, talking shit himself in AEW about WWE. We know how this goes in the end of the day, and yet Sasha Banks is just doing it. It's like it's par for the course when it comes to professional wrestling nowadays. And you know what? Okay, cool. Do you. That's you. But can you stop manipulating? She keeps doing this. She did this in the last video also, bruh. Can you stop? It's to the point now where, honest to God, this might be my last video. Unless she says something like super duper egregious where I just can't fucking ignore. I swear to God, this is all just not even clickbait. It goes even past that, bro. It's not even just so much the manipulative tactic of just gaslighting people. It's like, I think she's purposely saying shit. Not like, cause it's a difference. With clickbait, it's more of a manipulative tactic where you have a title, right? And you talk little about the title in itself, or you talk about it in a more roundabout way, where it's technically about the subject, but it doesn't go fully in depth with whatever title you have. Therefore, that's the clickbait in itself. I mean, clickbait could go to the extent of also, you know, you're just flat out fucking lying. But typically, most clickbait that I know, it's the title, and you do talk about it, but it's not to the extent of what the title has portrayed it to be, right? That's clickbait. She's just fucking saying shit just to get people to fucking listen to her. It doesn't matter if it makes any sense. It doesn't matter if it's an actual truth. It doesn't matter how manipulative it is. Bruh. So, first and foremost, Sasha, you left in 2022. My dude, you left in 2022. Almost every disagreement you had in WWE was underneath the Vince McMahon regime. Does she even attempt to mention that? Does she even attempt to mention that? No, she doesn't. She just looks over it. Just completely looks over it. But you think it gets better. It gets better within this passage. Because it's not just the fact that you just overlooked that nonsense, right? Triple H is in charge of WWE right now. One of his first things that he did while in power in NXT was make you, in particular, a pet project. You, Charlotte, Bailey, and Becky. But more in particular, you and Charlotte were his two pets. You guys were probably two. It's either what? It's Paige, arguably, and even then, I'm kind of like, eh. But let's just say Paige, because he was in charge of NXT at the time. Paige, Charlotte, and Sasha. Those were his first three women he really, 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 really hammered on in, right? Those are the first three women he really went really hard at as far as getting them over. You don't think to yourself that if you were in WWE right now, Triple H wouldn't treat you like a star? And by the way, even better, because you'd be seen throughout television, right? You'd actually be given material that doesn't expose you for how fucking trash you are as a wrestler. But of course, we just overlook that. We pretend that wouldn't be the case because it's very convenient to spin the narrative and make it seem as if your time in WWE, oh man, it was in shambles then and will be in much shambles now. You know what I wanted to talk about? And obviously she doesn't have to, nor do I think she will. And again, like I said, probably super personal. I'm very curious as to how those conversations went with Triple H back in 2023 when she was kind of negotiating whether or not she wanted to sign back with WWE. Remember all the rumors that was saying that there's a good shot that she's going to be showing up at the Royal Rumble in 2024 back in September or August last year, and how she was kind of weighing her options. Actually, that goes back a little bit further because I remember she was sitting in the AEW, what was it, All In last year, right, when she had the fucked up leg. So this goes back probably even around the springtime of 2023 when she was contemplating whether or not she wanted to sign for either company. You're really going to sit here and try to portray this situation? I think I know what's going on here. I think that you felt devastated that a guy like Triple H, who did treat you like a daughter, let's just call it what it is, he treated her like a daughter, right? And when the time came for you to renegotiate your contract, you know, and I want to say renegotiate because, you know, she left the company, maybe come back, and like, okay, let's see where I fit in this puzzle now that Triple H is in charge. He treated me so well in NXT back in the days. I wonder what he's going to do with my career, knowing good and damn well that I was one of his pillars in NXT. Well, golly gee willikers, look at what's happening with Becky Lynch. Well, golly gee willikers, look at what's happening with Charlotte Flair. God only knows he's going to treat me right, right? I was a team player. I helped put over Bianca Belair, another one of his pet peeves, right? Or pet students or whatever you want to call it, right? And then and I guarantee you, I know what happened. And I guarantee you, this is why she probably has animosity towards Triple H. Because that's what it is. You don't paint a picture out like that without suggesting that there's some animosity that you're harboring over the company that currently is being presided over the guy who made your career. Only thing I could possibly think of at the moment is that, well, yeah, you don't like the guy. And I think it has more to do with the fact that Triple H had to remind her that she's not on the level of a Becky Lynch or a Charlotte. No matter how I personally feel about the women, one thing that I can't ignore are the metrics. And here's the numbers that apparently Sasha Banks don't like listening to, especially when it's pointing directly in front of her face. See, that's the good thing about her AEW run. It's nothing but just exposing after exposing after exposing. Not just Sasha Banks, but all the dorks who thought they can actually get over without the WWE machine, right? What I see is a person who had to face reality, and she sees the numbers that Becky and Charlotte are putting up, more in particular Becky, and she notices my numbers aren't on par with her numbers. She notices that she is not the caliber of a superstar that Becky Lynch is. Whether I like her or whether I hate her, numbers don't lie, right? Numbers don't lie. And Triple H made a decision based off of that. He didn't make a decision based off of whether he likes Sasha or whether he hates Sasha. He made a decision based off of what is that going to do for my career when I have to show some of these reports, when I have to do the equivalent of inventorying, when I have to do the equivalent of, you know, loss and prevention. Like, when I have to show these finance reports to my higher-ups, how the fuck do I justify Sasha Banks getting this much money for this low of engagement versus what Becky Lynch is doing? It just makes no sense. And Sasha had to face that reality. That's why I think of it. I think Sasha had to face that reality. And Triple H essentially told her, we're not going to do what you think you... Or better yet, we're not going to do what you want us to do. There is a value attached to this. You earn what you worked for. Sasha, you are not a superstar. Sasha, you are not a draw. That's what I think happened. Triple H told us, you're not a draw. You're not a fucking draw. And Sasha got super duper angry. So I'm not going to get the same contract that Becky Lynch. So you're saying that I'm not the caliber of a star I always thought I was? But all my different wigs say otherwise. I starred in The Mandalorian. I was in The Mandalorian. I was the girl in The Mandalorian.
Shut the fuck up. No. No one cares. No one cares. No one cares.
And you know what you're doing, bruh. You paint yourself out to be this oh so lovely victim, and apparently people have to fall for the shit. People think because they're within their bubble on social media that follow Sasha Banks all the goddamn time, they think it's just like politics to a certain degree, where apparently Republicans actually believe that all the things that they say about Kamala Harris that the rest of the world understands, because apparently they legitimately think, because they're into politics as much as we are into politics, they think the rest of the world engages with politics like that. So when they see the mistakes that Kamala Harris makes, or they see Kamala Harris running, they think, oh, this is going to be easy, because all the stuff that we've been seeing within our echo chamber, that means that everybody else is gonna see it. No, no one engages with politics like that but us fucking dorks, right? Same thing can be said about Sasha Banks and her stupid ass dance. You guys don't understand that you following Sasha Banks, you liking Sasha Banks, has nothing to do with how everybody else feels about Sasha Banks. And it's even worse because it's not just Sasha Banks, it's professional wrestling as a perception as a whole that apparently people don't fucking recognize, does not engage with the rest of the world like it used to be. They use finances and figures given to them by contracts who need stability in order to, you know, have something, you know, just a constant traffic of revenue coming in right now. They confuse, for an example, within professional wrestling being popular, if you will, they confuse a company who has their hands in different things, right? Companies with different revenue streams. It can't just be like how it was back in the days, where you can have one or two or three revenue streams and make the bulk of your money this way. Now you have a 30 or 40 different things you're plunking your hand into, right? And wrestling happens to be one of those things at the moment, right? It's like a fucking octopus. It's almost like a genre and subgenres, right? You got the big genre being the corporation, and the subgenre happens to be wrestling at the moment. So they get a bunch of money because it's the stability that matters in the end of the day, right? And they take the figure of money, and they say to themselves, well, professional wrestling is as big as it's ever been before. They take the factor of not recognizing inflation when it comes to tickets, right? They take the factor of not recognizing that your social media numbers in regards to what is engaging at the very moment does not really compare to the rest of everything else that we see on social media in regards to their engagement as far as their entertainment platform, right? It doesn't really compute with me when you take the attitude and you say that, well, look at how low an engagement it has then versus now. What's your metric? You're going to compare Twitter in 2024 to Twitter in 1998, you stupid bitch? That's what I mean. This is the false sense of security that these people mess with. They see crowd size and then they think to themselves, wow, that should be a great indication. Not taking anything into context as far as comps are concerned. not taking into context as far as the advertising is concerned, not taking into context as far as how they used to actually advertise ahead of time compared to how WWE used to advertise ahead of time a couple of years ago. It's so many obvious factors that these people ignore, and they try to pretend that this whole situation is nuanced, but you stay within the bubble and you see professional wrestling for what it happens to be currently at the moment, and you want to compare it to actual things that legitimately occurred that was fucking actually probable and profitable and promisable and all these words that I'm fucking saying right now. I live in La La Land. I live in stupid land. And the same thing that you're seeing right now as far as how people engage with professional wrestling as far as their cope is considered, because they themselves want to be attached to something so desperately. They hate hearing how people talk about the past and how everything was so fucking cool, and now you have everything that's so manufactured nowadays. They themselves just want to be a part of something, and they would desperately manipulate whatever that entity happens to be in order to say that they're a part of something special. And they stay within this bubble. And like I said, that same attitude that you're hearing right now as far as professional wrestling is considered, that same attitude that you're hearing right now as far as politics are considered, it's a whole cope system, a whole coping mechanism, and it comes right back to Sasha Banks and her stupid-ass fans. And then you get all gobsmacked, and you sit back and you say to yourself, well, Sasha, she's not making $800,000? $700,000? Sasha Banks, the boss, the CEO, she's not really a draw? No shit, she's not a draw. She's never been a fucking draw. You just stay in your hive mind and you think to yourself that the world that you're immediately open to, that the world that you immediately have access to, you think to yourself that world right there that no one goes into, that you see 100 or 1,000 people within that bubble, that apparently is your entire world, and outside of that world are millions upon millions of other people who don't exist within your world. It's the whole louder voices versus the actual, you know, number of people. Don't confuse louder voices with the number of people. Sasha's not a star. And I'm tired of what she's doing right now. Like I said, unless something happens that's dramatically big, unless something happens where I have no choice but to legitimately engage with it because it's just that big of a topic, I'm done. I'm done covering Sasha Banks. This is it. No more. I've made like maybe 5 videos on her within the last 2 or 3 weeks. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. This is it. No more. Unless it's just something insane, like a backstage fight or some shit. And watch how I say that and watch how it fucking happens, right? No more. I'm done. Nada. Zilch. Key. Whoop. Taking it, throwing it across the sea. I don't want to speak about Sasha Banks anymore. Mercedes Mone, I don't want to speak about her anymore. It's all cope. It's all spite. Half the things that she says, I don't even think she legitimately believes. She just says it for the sake of saying it, just to fucking, hell, get goofs like me to talk about it, right? At least some men have to fucking admit it. Although, I mean, the feeling's mutual because I'm using you to get clicks, so who's really using who, right? Who's the bitch and who isn't the bitch, right? It's not even so much entitlement anymore. Like I said, it goes well beyond being manipulative, in my opinion. You know, it's spiteful. It's spite. It's anger. It's revenge. If Sasha had her way right now, the amount of money that she's making in AEW, if she was offered half of that in WWE, I guarantee you she would take it just to support her ego. Just to say that she's actually legitimately number one within the entire wrestling industry. Because you can't be number one in AEW. That's impossible. Not when WWE exists. She can't take the fact that she's not wanted and she's not even needed within WWE. She can't take the fact that what she believes her worth and her value is, it's only confirmed by the second best company in the world. Can you imagine? Can you imagine the girl who thinks she's all that? Who thinks because she has a bunch of geeks, a bunch of losers chasing after her, gawking over her? Well, see, it's a lot different when you have a bunch of these out of weight, these overbites, these nerds with the glasses running around with the bow tie on. You know, they smell like their closet. It's different when they're chasing after you. Because you think to yourself, I put all this time and effort into me. I should get the best. I worked on myself. I deserve better. But this is what you're open to. But Then out comes this jock. I mean, you spent the entire time laughing at these peons trying to get at you. Out comes the jock. The top 1%. Right? The top 1% guy. Dude is making buku's amount of money. Dude is super in shape. Dude has the face of a goddess and the body of a goddess. Pause. And you think because all these guys chasing after you, you think you're top shit now. So you think to yourself, oh gosh, he ain't gonna turn me down. I worked on myself. These guys love me. Until reality slaps you in the face and you are now one of the nerds who are chasing after you. Because this guy right here, the top 1%, has 99% of women right there in an open field. And you think your attitude, you think your value, you think your worth is worth a damn to him because these nerds and geeks are chasing after you? These nerds and geeks that are chasing after you is symbolic of where you lie on the pecking order of things, Sasha. You are not a draw. With this attitude, thinking that your fans can consistently put you on a pedestal and make you believe you don't have to work any further, to make you believe that you're forever going to be in this position of being the quote-unquote boss, let them keep boosting your ego up like that. Keep thinking that you have nothing to work on because they say you don't. But don't be shocked. Don't be shocked when the jock turns you down. And there are other women out there. Seems like they have more than what you have to offer. As always, my name is Devontae, and I'll be back later tomorrow or tonight, depending if something else blows up in the news. Hopefully tomorrow, though. Deuces, P, ice.